欢迎收看《有趣的灵魂》限定版八月恐怖悬疑新番《致命感二：伪装成恶的幸福》。话说，2018年末，路易斯安那州新奥尔良周边地区一个名叫勒卡雷的小镇，克拉克森冷冻肉食品加工厂中，有人在某个神秘的区域中发现了一具被冻在巨型冰块中的女尸。严格意义上说，他已经不再完整了。死者名为丽斯·克拉克森。令人感到困惑的是，他本是死于2005年，可尸体直到近14年之后的2018年末才被人重新发现。于是乎，一时激起千层浪，联邦调查局立刻开始重新审视这个本已完结的案件。直到2019年初，他们派出了一男一女二人组去调查当年某个曾经负责调查此案的特殊人物。这个人如今隐居在波尔顿城郊某栋老旧的公寓中。女探员阿里亚·戴维斯和波尔顿分部的分析师西蒙·琼斯临危受命，来到那栋公寓。阿里亚一路上都在忍受搭档西蒙的各种抱怨，后者直言，如果不是这个突如其来的尸体，他可能早就出现在加勒比某小岛上，享受果汁、披萨和美女作伴了。而阿里亚探员则是一位工作狂，他年纪轻轻，但凭借特殊的直觉和判断力，一直被部门视为年轻有为的典范。他看不顺眼身边这个一直喋喋不休的饭桶搭档，不断讽刺他对于披萨的狂热。
Pizza is not junk. Pizza is a sacred food bestowed upon us by God Himself.You need to apologize right now. This is sheer blasphemy.
Apologize to who? Pizza or God?
Maybe if you'd eaten pizza this morning like a decent person, you wouldn't have cut your finger.
I only cut my finger because I couldn't find a left-handed can opener at the hotel. Normally, I would never make such an amateur mistake.
Oh, really? Well, if you want me to get into gear, then just feed me some pizza.Okay.
两个人在楼道中拌嘴了5分钟之后，准备正式实施行动。
Agent Jones, don't let him take control of the conversation. The moment you let your guard down, he'll strike. And no red, remember?
It's open. Come on in.
This 间老旧的公寓中，光线阴暗，到处弥漫着灰尘，一股难以形容的味道扑鼻而来。而靠窗的位置坐着一具枯萎的如同干尸一样的男人。
You have questions for us. That's why you're here, isn't it?
Alia 和西蒙进入之后，发现这里和案发现场似乎没有两样。Alia 将行李挂在了衣架上，准备对面前这位前联邦调查局特别探员弗朗西斯·扎克·摩根展开一系列的质问。
Mr. Morgan, before we question you, allow me to first read you your rights. Anything you say may be used against you in a court of law.Please keep that in mind as you speak. Do we have permission to film this?
Don't worry, my fairy. They're free to do whatever they like.
Something wrong, Mr. Morgan? I'm FBI Special Agent Aaliyah Davis, and this is...
Simon Jones. An analyst from the Boston branch. He's been monitoring us for years now.
Hi.
Seriously.
A Southern belle and a lonesome loser who can't catch a break. Quite the uncanny duo. You'd be the perfect stars for the latest video game. Isn't that right, my fairy? How many years has it been since someone came to chat with us? Oh, but don't ask me about my fairy. That's a private matter.
阿里亚紧盯着眼前的扎克，内心中思考着如何与他对峙。他就像储藏秘密的保险箱，想要从他嘴中挖出什么线索，比榴莲泡豆汁喝出香味还要有难度。他似乎早已堕落成一位瘾君子，冲着房间中弥漫的麻叶气味，很难想象他能说出什么对自己有利的证词。在阿里亚的印象中，这位扎克曾经被称为最具才华的探员，至少在局里是一个传说一样的人物。阿里亚感觉到了一股强大的阻力，如果自己不使用一些特殊的物件来动摇面前这个人的意志，恐怕自己会立刻陷入被动。
You solved many difficult cases across your career. Utilizing your own unique MO, you've expertly cracked cases that were otherwise thought to be unsolvable. According to our records, after joining the FBI in 2002, you quickly solved two drug ring-related kidnapping cases. In 2003, you solved the inside-out flesh skinner case in the suburbs of Pittsburgh. In 2004, the Jeffrey Dahmer wannabe case in Milwaukee. And also the stuffed human collector case in St. Louis that very same year. Then, in 2005, you coincidentally happened to solve the Lise Clarkson murder case while on vacation. You went on to solve many other cases after that, all of them seemingly inexplicable. Did you really solve these cases all on your own? There are no records of you using a wide-scale investigative team or working with anyone else. How did you ever accomplish such monumental feats all by yourself?
It was all thanks to our talented partner.
Partner. The FBI files show no record of you ever working with a partner. Do you mean you worked with some sort of unofficial partner or an outside confidant?
Our partner is our partner. We've always worked together. Besides, Belle, you're forgetting one important thing. After the St. Louis case, we stopped by a diner on our way home and caught Thelma and Louise, two highly sought-after fugitives.
Excuse me, Mr. Morgan, but would you please refrain from consuming that while we speak? I'm talking about... Yes, that.
You don't need to worry about us. Don't get in our way, and we won't get in yours.
Unfortunately, questioning doesn't work like that. Our data needs to be consistent. Now please put out that stinking indulgence right this minute.
What if we say no?
Then I'll put it out myself. Using force.
Whoa, whoa, Aaliyah! This is Morgan's house. Besides, it's legal in Massachusetts for individuals to consume cannabis in the comfort of their own homes. And I mean, come on.
It's medicinal.
Exactly.
Hey, Belle. Why are you dressed so handsomely?
What are you talking about?
The thick black accessory wrapped around your neck. That's a male necktie. The color black represents confidence and interest in the self. And your decision to wear a male tie symbolizes your declaration of war against a predominantly male society. Or perhaps it's a psychological barrier meant to hide the weakness that dwells deep within your psyche. We admire your bravery.
I thought you retired from profiling.
Bullseye, huh? You're an easy one to read.
In order to think with society, a man must first gouge out his eyes and cut off his ears. Don't judge a book by its cover. For someone who's supposed to have been one of our best, you've got an awful eye for people. Or did all that smoke and kill all your little gray cells?
Okay, Aaliyah, that's enough. She's smart, but she's also more of a shrew than she lets on.
Agent Jones, that's sexual harassment.
So, Belle, does that barrier of yours also protect you from violent criminals?
扎克桌子上的古董棋盘让阿里亚感到不可思议，这是一盘刚下了一半的棋局，看似他是在独自下棋。此行阿里亚特意带来14年前那起扑朔迷离的勒卡雷凶案的档案，当年负责调查此案的正是自己面前的弗朗西斯·扎克·摩根。当年那个传说一样的他，如今似乎已经患上了四级恶性肿瘤。人在得知死亡将近的时候会产生什么样的变化？恶之花是否会绽放在贫瘠的土壤表面呢？于是乎，阿里亚质问扎克，当他得知死亡将近的时候是一种什么样的感受？扎克对于死亡似乎毫不在意，相对的，他非常享受烟草的味道，并且反手向阿里亚展开了质问。
Belle, have you ever been to the Grand Canyon in winter?
No.
In the dead of winter, the Grand Canyon is terribly cold, colder than you could imagine. A cold that no photograph could ever express. The sun, powerless, and the temperature drops below zero.Right in the middle of the day.
Meaning?
Meaning. You can't really understand something until you experience it for yourself. If you want to learn more about us, you need to gain more experience, Belle.
随后阿里亚质问扎克那个古董棋盘的来历，扎克表示棋盘和棋子产自19世纪的法国，全部由象牙制成，在后来被濒危物种国际公约所禁止，所以成为了绝版的存在。但阿里亚并不在意棋盘的来历，他只是怀疑扎克的公寓中还隐藏着其他神秘的人物。
There isn't a single chess book to be found in this apartment. And I didn't find any chess related websites in his internet history. He was simply playing chess. All alone.
So, what's wrong with that, Belle?
I don't understand it. How could a single human being seriously play as both sides?
You just publicly confessed to stealing personal data. Seems like that's a much bigger problem.
Oh no, everything was done in a perfectly legal manner. We simply happened to intercept a handful of data being sent out from an unknown origin.
Ooh, now she's really trying to scare us. Did you hear that, my fairy? Serious nightmare fuel.
Do you remember the homicides that took place in Lucare, Louisiana in 2005?
We solved that case.
Your report states the following. By coincidence, you encountered a serious incident in a town you visited while on vacation. You then decided to steal the right to investigate from the local law enforcement and took over the case. After several more homicides, you managed to apprehend the perpetrator.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, that's exactly what happened. We stole the right to investigate from them, just as you said.
It all started when the body of a 16-year-old girl was discovered. You arrived in Lucare immediately after that, didn't you?
We just can't seem to keep ourselves away from dead girls.
Did you really visit that town just to take a vacation?
We don't know. If you already have the report, then we suggest you read it, Bell. Either way, that case is closed.
Closed? You sure about that? Don't you think this puzzle is still missing some crucial pieces?
Come on. No need to beat around the bush with us, Bell.
They found Lise Clarkson's body. It was hidden deep within the Clarkson Food Delivery Services cold storage warehouse.
After 14 years, we finally discovered the body of the very first victim. Do you know what this means? That's why we're here.
We're pleased that her body turned up. Deeply pleased.
You claim to have closed this case. But now a lost body suddenly surfaced. Aren't you curious about the details?
Body or not, we already solved that case. Lisa's body can't change anything now. And it certainly has nothing to do with us.
I suspect the body was stored there rather than abandoned, due to the unnatural state it was found in. She was found frozen in a storage unit. Therefore, she looks exactly the same as she did when she disappeared. In fact, she's in such good condition that we can even determine the murder weapon and cause of death.
Well, good for you.
Even stranger is how unbelievably beautiful she looks. At first glance, few would guess she was a murder victim at all. She looks more like a piece of art, or a mythological figure from a painting.
This keeps getting better and better.
Better and better?
Isn't that right, my fairy? A corpse as beautiful as a goddess. Sounds just like our story.
You may be wondering why we decided to unearth all these old files.
Everything happens for a reason.
The moment Lise Clarkson's body was found, we did the best we could to start our own local investigation. But there wasn't much we could actually investigate due to the damage caused by the hurricane.
Then we assume you also questioned everyone who worked in the warehouse.
Of course. We questioned all the Clarkson Food Delivery Services employees who staffed the warehouse and its owner. But we still have yet to obtain any key testimonies.
Par for the course with a 14-year-old case, if you ask me.
Not to mention how bad the timing was. Most of the employees were on vacation.
So, you gave up on the investigation and came to see us instead. Remember what happened, my fairy? That warehouse. That man. So incoherent. Such a pain.
Hey, are you talking about the guy who managed the vault where Lisa's body was found? Yeah, I think he started working there in 2005. Remember, Aaliyah? You said he was a pain to deal with, too.
Isn't there someone else you should have talked to? Before coming to us? Such as...
We were unable to reach Patricia Clarkson. You look surprised. I thought you already knew. After all, you visited Louisiana last week. We assumed you met with her during your time there.
We haven't been to Louisiana. Not in 14 years.
Is that so?
We've been right here in our apartment this entire time. That man is our witness. Aren't you, Simon?
He's right. He didn't even take a single step outside on Christmas Eve, which means that I didn't get to either.
Are you positive about that? I took the liberty of checking some airline records. Last Friday, the name Billy Bishop was listed on a morning flight out of Boston. This is the fake name you used to use as an agent, isn't it?
A mere coincidence.
Yet that's not all. That evening on the same day, a man with a large scar on his forehead allegedly purchased an 89 Cadillac from a small used car lot in Lucare. He reportedly said he wanted something old, big, and strong. The owner of the car lot felt it was a strange order, so it stuck in his mind.
Our world is filled with mysteries. And they always have the most bizarre timing.
Incidentally, on the following day, an identical Cadillac was taken to a scrapyard in Trenton. Trenton, New Jersey.
You can find that type of car anywhere. Isn't that right, my fairy?
阿里亚并不相信扎克的话，他依然认为后者在别有用心地回避着某些秘密，甚至认为他患有某些人格障碍。于是他将目光投射到了公寓中的其他角落，比如那摞老旧的 DVD 收藏。一个将死之人真有心思看电影吗？其次，桌子上一个显眼的三角形痕迹，在这个灰尘弥漫的房间中，那是唯一一个一尘不染的位置。人类很难精确地清理这样一处位置。阿里亚认为扎克肯定是把一个原本放在这儿的东西给藏起来了，还有那些随处可见的营养液和注射剂。如果他像自己说的那样不畏惧死亡，那么为何还要如此填补自己的身体呢？于是阿里亚开始针对性地质问扎克。关于 DVD 收藏，他似乎很享受这植物一样的生活。眼看阿里亚对电影一窍不通，扎克立刻对他的精神嘲讽了一番。有趣的灵魂，谁会不喜欢看电影呢？电影在某种程度上引导着人类的精神世界。眼看着败下阵来，阿里亚立刻用其他的线索来对峙。他提到了公寓水池中刚刚用完的榨汁机和那些随处可见的营养液。为何一个号称不惧怕死亡的人会如此努力地抵抗呢？这和他刚刚提到的话完全相悖，但扎克回应，矛盾是普遍的，人类的内心和天平没什么区别，成熟的思想应该平衡于其中。这让阿里亚一时无言以对，于是开始质问桌子上那个三角形区域的事情，他是不是有意隐藏了什么不想被看到的东西。扎克回应，那片三角形区域是一间圣所，来自于某个神秘的房间中，里边藏着灵魂和诸多神秘的物质，没有人可以看见它原本的样子。似乎扎克对于这个所谓的隐形物体非常的真实，原本有利的形式被扎克逆风翻盘。阿里亚脑海中唯一能想到的证据只有一份特殊的档案了，那可能是唯一能刺激到扎克的存在，而自己那个废柴搭档西蒙探员磨叽了好半天才拿出那份档案。
Mr. Morgan, do you recognize these files?
Ow!
We told you. That's a sanctuary.
Let him go! Assaulting an FBI agent is an obstruction of justice.
We told you. Go. Stay back. Stay back. Sanctuary. Down. Surrounding.
Mr. Morgan?
让扎克反应如此强烈的原因，竟是阿里亚手指伤口上渗出的血迹。
I cut my finger with that can opener this morning. I thought I stopped the bleeding, but it seeped through. How could I be so stupid?
阿里亚很是疑惑，为何扎克如此畏惧红色？一切似乎都和十年前那件发生于华盛顿州雨林镇的离奇凶案有关联。阿里亚注意到公寓厨房边还有一台巨大的碎纸机。倘若扎克内心诚如明镜，那为何要放置这么一个东西？很明显，他在过去的几年中销毁了大量的文件。阿里亚质问扎克，为何要在退休后依然如此担心自己的各种信息呢？ 扎克表示这只是他多年养成的习惯，以防止一些别有用心之人前来翻箱倒柜。而扎克始终拒绝透露那个三角形区域的更多秘密。于是西蒙也开始帮腔，认为倘若任何人也看不到摸不到那个三角形圣所，那么扎克本人是如何清理那片区域的呢？然而扎克并没有鸟他。接下来阿里亚把为数不多的有利细节拿来最后一试。
Mr. Morgan, I'd like to ask you some questions about this case now.
We don't want to remember that town.
I'm sorry, but there's no way around this. I remember hearing about this case on the news when I was still a student. A high school girl named Anna Graham was murdered and the FBI stepped in to take over the case. I also remember it becoming a sprawled investigation due to evidence found in the victim's throat. Is that correct?After that case, you went on sick leave for 2 years. And when you returned, you requested to be switched over to desk work. What happened?
That's a private matter. None of your business, Bill.
Were you traumatized? It's a common problem with prolific agents such as yourself. But there's another possibility that may make more sense. Perhaps you simply finished making preparations.
What are you getting at?
Thinking too much about something will always turn it into a problem. The Greenvale case. Don't you think it resembles the Luke Carre case?
Read the report. We have nothing else to say.
Looks like another old antique. You like clocks?
Clocks are amazing.Prime fruit of the human race's intellect. We took the invisible idea of time and manifested it in these.
Yeah, I love clocks too. Absolutely fascinating.
I disagree.
Oh? Why?
Time is valuable precisely because it can't be seen. Yet nowadays people can't tell what time it is unless it's measured in numbers.Talk about idiocy. I don't mean to side with the Board of Longitude, but remember, humans used to cross oceans with the stars alone. We have our eyes to read moon charts and study the sky. We don't need clocks.
What if it's cloudy or storming?
All you need is courage and a love for adventure.
Hear that, my fairy? Courage?And a love for adventure? Come on, Belle. Surely you know how many lives have been claimed by your pals' courage and adventure.
A jar of honey with honeycomb inside it.
That's royal jelly.
Huh?
You were staring at the jar, weren't you? Do you find it strange that there's honeycomb inside? We wanted to harvest royal jelly in its most...natural state. The queen's main food source, created from the worker bee's secretions. It's a perfect food, filled with power, meant to fuel the birth of the next queen. By absorbing it into our own bodies, we too can acquire that power. Incidentally, did you know that all the worker bees are female?
No.
Guess they didn't teach you that at Quantico. Male bees are only born to inseminate, and they're born from unfertilized eggs to boot. They have short lives and don't even get stingers. Sort of feels like a glimpse into the future of our society, wouldn't you agree? Women are gifted with the power to conceive, give birth, and nourish their children. But men are consumed with the job of providing women with the chance to do so. If women no longer had to rely on men for the seeds of life, they would soon cease to desire them, we believe. Be careful, Simon.
Huh? Of what?
Your Belle's already stolen the reins from you.
最终，阿俩只得拿出杀手锏，某张特殊的照片。
Mr. Morgan, please look at this.
What did we just say? We don't want to remember Greenvale.
This isn't a photo from Greenvale. Look closely at it. Former Special Agent Francis Zack Morgan. This photograph predates Greenvale. It's from the Lucare case you worked on in 2005.
Red. Red tree. Red tree.
Yes. A red tree. Greenvale wasn't the first place you saw one of these. The Greenvale case and the Lise Clarkson murder case. They're connected by these red trees, aren't they?
Red trees.
Answer me. What are these trees?
Red trees.
I want the truth. Tell me everything you know.
The red trees. You really did your homework. Well done, Belle. You're good. Damn good.
Are you ready to talk now? I want to know what went down in Lucare in 2005.
Fine. We'll tell you. We'll tell you what happened in that town. Yes. It was that red tree. That red tree ruined my life. It was a sultry summer day. The sun comes down hard on you in the south, like a torrential downpour of demonic whispers. It all started back in that sweltering summer. We still had our best friend with us back then. The other me. My better half.
When somebody needs you, you can't turn away. You're their only lifeline, just a hero, a bullet for hire, working alone. Always a voice, a cry in the darkness, an echo of pain that's been long forgotten, but it haunts me. My destiny to be alone. There's a time when you see life for what it's gotta be. You should know they'll destroy. Call to me to keep searching, walk alone.